Listen, a number of people signed that open letter. Okay. So this isn't just about Byron Allen. This is about everybody.
It's always a pleasure to sit down and talk with the great Byron Allen. Byron Allen, as you know, is the owner of Entertainment Studios that is the parent company of theGrio, where I happen to be White House correspondent and Washington bureau chief. And today we're talking to him because he's in the news yet again. Byron Allen is suing McDonald's. Yes, McDonald's, the fast food chain, for $10 billion because they have not stepped up to the plate when it comes to Black-owned media and their advertising dollars. Now, before we get into this conversation, McDonald's has had a complicated relationship with Black America since the Civil Rights era. And now we hear about this next level, this time with Byron Allen. Byron, please discuss why you are filing this lawsuit.
Well, first of all, April, it's great to see you and thank you for having me on. Listen, this is very important. You know, I've said it in a number of times that, you know, Coretta Scott King, Martin Luther King's widow, expressed that we as Black people have four major challenges in this country. Number one, end slavery. Number two, end Jim Crow. Number three, achieve civil rights. And number four, the real reason they killed my Martin, achieve economic inclusion. The very first civil rights statute in America, the Civil Rights Act of 1866, Section 1981, and this is the very first that was put on the books almost 160 years ago, it was put on the books to address economic inclusion for the newly freed slaves. That is the very first one. And here we are, almost 160 years later, and we still haven't achieved economic inclusion. And that is the greatest trade deficit in America, the trade deficit between white corporate America and Black America. And we have to close that gap to have real, real civil rights in America. This is the biggest pressing civil rights issue in America. All of this lack of economic inclusion, it's giving a pathway to the other issues in our community. And we have a lot of issues in our community, but you can resolve a lot of those issues with economic inclusion, education, a safe environment, jobs, businesses. We are being, as Black America, we are suffering from economic genocide. We are suffering from economic exclusion. And we have to close that gap. And what I've said to corporate America, you have to do business with Black America in a meaningful way. And you just can't look at us like we are a Negro problem. And how little can I throw these Negroes so they shut up, go away, and I can get back to my white privileged life? We have to have real, meaningful economic inclusion. And that's a big problem. And we will not be one America, and we will not truly achieve the civil rights that need to be achieved, which was the very first civil rights statute, until we have meaningful economic inclusion.
Byron, what do you say to people who are not hearing all of this about economic inclusion and about rights? Because you stand for rights. You have gone to court, gone to the Supreme Court over issues of rights. But what do you say to people who are saying this is extortion, not about economic inclusion?
Yeah, you know, listen, here's what I say. The only time that, you know, America, you know, wants to use the word Black is when they're talking about a suspect. When it's time to talk about money and it's time to talk about economic inclusion and it involves Black people, then all of a sudden they start saying terrorists, extortionists. Where's the extortion? You brought my Black here from Africa to build the most powerful, wealthiest nation in the world. That's the extortion. That's the terrorism. You just forgot to include my Black in the economic ecosystem of America. So what we said to McDonald's is you have 39,000 stores throughout this country. You're bringing in over $100 billion a year. A lot of that coming from Black people, your workforce, a lot of that Black people, your chairman, your CEO, his personal compensation is just under 11 million. That's more than what you spent on all of Black-owned media combined. Black-owned media is almost out of business. See, when we get the right partnership, when we get the right economic support, it allows me to employ amazing people like you. And when you are working at a company that's getting squeezed out economically, they're not able to keep a great April Ryan on the payroll. All of these are symptoms of lack of economic exclusion. And that's not extortion. That's not terrorism. That's closing a trade gap and saying to white corporate America, you have to do business with Black America the way we're doing business with you. And when you don't, that impacts our communities, our jobs, as whether or not somebody like an April can send her kids to college to get a great education so they can go off to that amazing career. All of that, or she can own a house and she can own the house of her dreams. She works hard enough, she deserves it. And can she get that house or that car loan at a great interest rate because she's consistently employed and paid a really good salary? This is closing a trade deficit. This isn't extortion. This is, why is it okay for us as Black people to do so much business with you, McDonald's, and you do so little business with us? That's really what this is about.
In some sectors of America, McDonald's is considered Black, and you are a numbers cruncher.
Yes.
Give us the numbers, Black income going into McDonald's and the outpour to Black media. Can you give us that ratio?
Tens of billions of dollars going into McDonald's out of Black America. Tens of billions, with less than 5 million of their $1.6 billion ad budget, less than 5 million going to Black-owned media. That's indefensible. That's unacceptable. In my humble opinion, that is economic genocide.
With all that you said, you have, in this lawsuit that you announced last week, you've now placed all of these massive ads, articles about this very issue that you brought, this lawsuit, this $10 billion with a B lawsuit against McDonald's, the franchise that's known around the world. What realistically are you expecting from this major promotion about this lawsuit? Are you talking to McDonald's heads? Are you expecting to get something for yourself and others? What is the reality out of this lawsuit and these ads that you're placing? This is basically, you're putting this basically in the court of public opinion with these ads now.
Listen, a number of people signed that open letter, okay? So this isn't just about Byron Allen. This is about everybody. And this isn't a conversation with just McDonald's. This is a conversation with every corporation in America. This isn't just McDonald's. This is every corporation. Read the open letter. It's signed by Roland Martin and Todd Brown. And it's signed by all these, Butch Graves, who owns Black Enterprise. Read that letter, okay? So it's everybody. And this is a conversation about Black America not getting an equal share and not participating in a real trade relationship that's equitable for both sides. So what I expect to happen is that what we requested, I expect Chris Kaczynski to sit with us on a one-hour Zoom call. And like I've said, I want to look in your eyes. I want to hear it in your voice. I want it to come from your soul that you're sincere, that you're going to provide real economic inclusion for Black America, and not just in media, because, hey, he's having problems with Black executives that have sued McDonald's. Let's not forget that. Black franchisees have sued or are suing McDonald's for being relegated to bad areas. Let's not forget that. Where there's smoke, there's fire. And now when you find out that Black-owned media is going, I'm not getting anything. I'm getting very little. Out of one point, Black America, come on now. You got to come off the plantation. We have got to come off the plantation. What is okay with somebody spending way over $1 billion a year advertising and Negroes get damn near zero? What is okay about that, Black America? You're not a charity. You are kings and queens, and literally royalty rolls through your blood. But yet you are still acting like it's okay to treat me like nothing. That doesn't work, Black America. If we're going to change our condition, we're going to get a calculator and we're going to know the numbers and we're going to hold white corporate America accountable. That's what we've never done. See, I'm the first Negro to come along in over 400 years and sue corporate America for, now at this point, over $50 billion.
Who's next? What company's next?
Everybody who's not doing business with Black America.